At this time, WQXR is privileged to present a unique event, the first radio broadcast of a recital by Vladimir Horowitz. For many months, the standing room only sign has been posted for this Horowitz concert in Carnegie Hall. Tonight, as always when the pianist makes a New York appearance, not only every seat in the hall, but even the stage itself has been pressed into service. The chairs that have been arranged around the great ebony concert grand add comparatively little to the capacity of Carnegie Hall, but they do provide a few hundred more music lovers the opportunity of hearing Mr. Horowitz. In agreeing to have WQXR broadcast the second half of this evening's recital, Mr. Horowitz has extended his audience far beyond the confines of New York City. Music lovers in the metropolitan area hearing this recital on WQXR, and those in upstate New York, Connecticut, Pennsylvania, and elsewhere who are listening to the Rural Radio FM network, can tonight for the first time share in the musical experience of those here at Carnegie Hall. Thus, Mr. Horowitz's performance tonight renders a great service to the public. Next year, we will be entirely deprived of his playing, for he will not reappear in New York until 1953, when he'll celebrate the 25th anniversary of his American debut. During the next hour, WQXR will broadcast the entire second half of the Horowitz recital, including the encores, which are always demanded of this famous artist. We are to hear now Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition. This piano suite was written in 1874 as Mussorgsky's tribute to the architect and painter Victor Hartmann, who had died suddenly during the previous year. The composer visited a posthumous exhibition of the artist's watercolors and drawings, and the Pictures at an Exhibition refer for the most part to items hung in that show. Vladimir Horowitz has made his own arrangement of the Mussorgsky score. He has sought as far as possible to restore the character of the music as the composer originally conceived it. As Olin Downs has said, Mr. Horowitz's editing of Mussorgsky's pieces is in no sense an effort to compete with the orchestral transcriptions or to introduce any extraneous elements into the music as Mussorgsky wrote it. It is a return to the original manuscript. Following it carefully, Mr. Horowitz has created what might be described as a piano orchestration. Now, Mr. Horowitz is stepping out onto the stage, and here is the applause that greets him. In this first broadcast of a recital by Vladimir Horowitz, we hear Pictures at an Exhibition by Mussorgsky. The work opens with a promenade, and then the picture, Gnomes. Thank you. Promenade, a medieval castle, and again promenade. Thank you. children at play in the Tuileries. Low and Promenade. Ballet of the Unhatched Chicks. Thank you. Two men, one rich, the other poor. Marketplace gossip and catacombs. Thank you. dead in a dead language.
Thank you.
stage of Carnegie Hall, WQXR has brought you Vladimir Horowitz performing Pictures at an Exhibition by Modest Mussorgsky. Tonight, Mr. Horowitz is heard in his first recital ever to be presented on the air. With the Pictures at an Exhibition, Mr. Horowitz has concluded the scheduled portion of his program, but the audience is sure to call the great pianist back to the stage for some additional works. Always at a Horowitz recital, the audience calls for more encores and still more encores. That desire is heightened this evening by the knowledge that Mr. Horowitz will not appear in New York again until 1953. And now, Vladimir Horowitz has returned to the stage once more, and here is his first encore for the evening.
Thank you. Just heard the first encore by Vladimir Horowitz in tonight's Carnegie Hall recital. It was the Scarlatti Sonata in E Major, Longo number 23. Again, the applause calls Mr. Horowitz back to the stage. He bows first to the audience and then to those seated on the stage. He seats himself at the piano, and here is our second encore. Robert Schumann's familiar Träumerei was the second encore in tonight's Horowitz recital, which we are bringing to you from Carnegie Hall. Again, the tumultuous ovation greets Mr. Horowitz's performance. Again, he returns to the stage, bows first to the audience, seated in the house itself, and then to those on the stage. Whether we're going to get another encore or not remains to be seen. The audience, as you can hear, is clamoring for it. And I suspect that in a moment, Mr. Horowitz will return and will accede to the demand. Here he comes again, and now he is returning to the piano. We hear the third encore. Thank you. That was the third encore of tonight's recital by Vladimir Horowitz, the first such recital ever to be broadcast. And the pianist chose to play for us Étincelles or Sparks by Mostovsky. Now we hope for still another encore by Mr. Horowitz. The audience is calling for it. He has left the stage momentarily, but we expect him back in just a moment, at least to take a final bow, perhaps to play yet another encore. Yes, here's Mr. Horowitz striding across the stage to take his place at the keyboard of his Steinway. Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa in a transcription by Vladimir Horowitz. And you can hear that the audience has received it with wild acclaim, to put it mildly. Well, this has been the concluding encore in tonight's recital at Carnegie Hall. During the past hour, you have been listening to a unique event. For the first time in his extraordinary career, Vladimir Horowitz has broadcast a portion of one of his recitals. In performing this service for the musical public, he has made it possible for a large audience outside Carnegie Hall to enjoy his keyboard artistry. He's being called again and again to the stage to receive the plaudits of the audience here tonight. As we told you a little earlier, the desire to be here tonight, to hear him play, was heightened by the knowledge that Mr. Horowitz won't appear in New York again until 1953, which brings the 25th anniversary of his debut in this country. On that memorable occasion back in 1928, which also took place here in Carnegie Hall, Horowitz scored sensationally when he played the Tchaikovsky B-flat minor concerto. The conductor on that occasion, by the way, was Sir Thomas Beecham, who was making his American debut at the same concert. The pianist's European debut was given in Berlin, not in Paris, as is often stated, when he was 21 years old. After his first New York appearance, Mr. Horowitz returned to Europe every year until 1939, and this summer he intends to visit the continent for the first time since the beginning of the war. Well, as you can hear from the sounds in the background, the audience has finally consented to let Mr. Horowitz leave the stage. They, too, are filing out of the auditorium now, and so we come to the end of this evening's program, the first time that Vladimir Horowitz has broadcast a portion of one of his recitals. This is Bill Strauss speaking to you from Carnegie Hall, and bidding you all a very good evening. We return you now to our studios.